Good morning to one and all. This is the second class about these traffic signals. In this today's topic, we have to discuss what are the different types of traffic signals, what is the purpose of designing, how we have to use, and what are the needs and deeds for these traffic signals according to different places they are kept in. First of all, we discussed about these objectives. That means what is the purpose of keeping a traffic signal. That means we are normally in olden days we are having these traffic polices, so that day by day there may be a number of places are increasing due to the densification of this road system, so that we have to use these mechanic equipments, so like these all these electronic equipments, these traffic signals are. Why? Because in these traffic signals, we are using some amount of electronic gadgets and other things to control the traffic by a proper software system and engaging. Next one, all those are the different requirements of the traffic signals. First of all, we need to create some amount of awareness in the road users. After that, we have to enable those to use these particular traffic signals in different spaces. Next of all, provide sufficient time to respond to them, because with the lack of time, automatically there may be delay of the their journey, so that they have to respond with a sufficient time period, and they have to ensure for lack of waste of time. That means they need to have some amount of awareness how much amount of time we are having, so that at a particular time how they have to cross that particular space. And these are the advantages of the traffic signals. That means they provide direct movement of the traffic, and quality of traffic flow will be improved by these traffic signal systems, and this will decreases the quantity of accidents occurring on a particular space, and traffic handling capacity will be very high compared to normal persons. That means normal person will not be able to see overall the traffic, so that this traffic signals will be used for days and years also by a proper service of this current and other gadgets in the traffic signals. And they will provide a chance of traffic to minor amount of this but that means minor amount of these errors. Normally, if there is a person, means automatically due to several factors, they will have some amount of errors. But in case of these electronic equipments, there may be some less quantity of errors. Why? Because it is a software program. There may be less chance of occurring accidents. Next one, pedestrians also having some proper time for the moving. And the signal systems is properly coordinate with the particular traffic system and the particular areas. Automatic traffic signals may not work out in a different spaces, so that all those are the advantages. And what are the disadvantages? Means the rear end collisions, means back to back collisions will be occur in a particular spaces. Why because there may be a less span of space to flow a particular quantity of vehicles in those places, so that there may be some amount of disadvantages due to these rear end collisions. Next one, improper design and location of signals, they will lead to these problems. Improper design, that means there is no data, automatically they will use some quantity of data, so that due to those quantity of data that is not matching with the relative field itself, there may be some amount of accidents and other things. In some of the cases, there may be chance of failuring also. That means due to wind parameters and water parameters in rainy seasons, it may be having a chance of failure of these traffic signals. In those cases also, they need to face an amount of problems. Some of variation of vehicle arrivals. That means normally, if there is a same kind of vehicles, that means all the vehicles are class A, all the vehicles are class B, means there may be no chance of skipping or skidding. That means if there is any large containing vehicles are coming, automatically their speed will decreases the flow rate of the backing vehicles. That means whatever the vehicles which are in the back field, so that all the vehicles has to move in a slow manner so that there may be some amount of eclipse in the flow. Excessive delay also takes place due to large vehicles when they come into the particular fields, and some of the cases driver may also injured. These are the terms involved in this particular traffic design. First one, signal cycle. The total complete cycle means the all line users has to move for a one pattern. Means 1, 2, 3, 4 lines are there, or four patterns are simply moving, means the total phase is over. Next one, single phase means if a single road is completely moving, means it is comes under single phase. Red phase and green phases are simply when the lights are blowing in red color, automatically vehicle has to stop, or green color means automatically vehicle has to move. After that, intervals. There may be some amount of intervals to these road users for a less kind of traffic. If there is a less quantity of traffic in your area, so that there may be you some intervals. And next one is the designer. That means the engineer has to takes place all those activities, and they need to have data about the particular traffic flow and the lengths there of the road and width of the road and the area of by particular people and the people education levels and all other things they need to know. After that, they have to go for design and the level of service also. It means level of service means the what is the total length of the road, what is the total width of the road, what is the volume of the road, particular quantity of vehicles, how he has to give a better level of service, all those things. Next one, we have to go for this traffic signals means normally these traffic signals are mainly meant for decreasing the accidents and increasing the flow parameters. First of all, we are having traffic control signals. These majorly red signal and green signals are these traffic control signals used for the movement control of the vehicles. Means the movement control means the vehicle is simply moving, means there is a red green signal. The vehicle is stopping means there is a red signal. Likely all those are traffic control signals. Next one, pedestrian signal means normally in the roads itself we are having these pedestrians, those who are using their feet for the journey, so that we have to give some amount of importance to the pedestrians, and we need to employ a separate kind of line system for the pedestrians, and we need to use some amount of lights also, different color lights. In special traffic signals, that means if there is any important persons or political persons or any other army or navy battalion forces are simply moving on those roads, we need to give some specific time period to those traffic vehicles. That means those are important vehicles, for that we have to use a special traffic signals for them also. What is the traffic control signal? How why we have to use a traffic control signal? Have three colored lights which glow facing each different direction of traffic flow, namely red, amber and green. Normally here we are observing control signals have three colored lights. That means first one we are having red color, after that we are having this amber color. That means normally it is in the color of orange, it is called as an amber color. After that we are having this green color. Why? Because those three will having parameters to control, that means flowing parameters, all those things they are maintained by these three signals. First one, the red light is meant for stopping a vehicles in a particular lanes. If there is a huge lane, so that this red symbol is used. Why? Because red having more visibility in nature. Why? Because in WebGR, whenever the white light is sent to a particular prism, so that the white light can be deviates into 6 or 7 number of colors. So WebGR means violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red, so that the total number of the total white light can be dispersed into these 7 lights. So that in those 7 lights we are mainly choosing this green color and red color. Why? Because this green and red having a better visible capacities to the all driver, all kind of peoples. Why? Because this green and red colors are the having more amount of this frequency in terms of this light phenomena. So that these red color and green color are majorly using in the traffic signals. After that, we are having this amber signal. Those amber signals are normally used for the traffic clearance purpose. So simply at a 10 to 15 seconds, normally amber signal will be sprinkling, not blowing. Next one, the amber or yellow lights allows the clearance time for the vehicles which enter in a particular intersection area at the end of the green time to clear off the intersection before change over to red signal light. That means normally we are giving a particular time period to move the vehicles from one lane to another lane. Normally if there is a junction, automatically we have to employ these traffic signals. In the junction itself, the vehicles will have to move from one lane to another lane, so that we are giving a special period of time for the movement purpose. In some of the vehicles are simply joining at the end of the time. That means if the 30 seconds or 60 seconds are there, automatically at the 59th second or 57th second, simply few of the vehicles are coming into the lane, so that automatically we have to give a few seconds for this amber time. Otherwise the vehicles having a collision properties. The all vehicles are simply cleared in a particular route, means automatically we need to give this green signals to the another line of flowing vehicles, so that this amber is used for the mainly clearance pattern in a particular junction. If there is no clearance and we are giving a green light, means automatically those vehicles which are entered in a particular line at the 58th second or 60th second and exit of the time, automatically those having a chance of meeting accidents. So that we need to choose and have to observe all those kinds of vehicles, and we need to have to give some quantity of time, extra time, in the form of this amber or yellow light systems. Additional signals showing green lights are for separate movements of turning traffic movements may also be provided where there is necessary. That means additional signals showing green lights in some of the areas we are having this mixed traffic flow. That means different kinds of vehicles and different purposes of vehicles are flowing in a single lane system, so that for those vehicles also we have to give some amount of extra signals for their movement, so that for better traffic flow patterns and better traffic flow systems, we have to give some amount of extra time for those vehicles by showing simply this green light sparking whenever the vehicles are moving. Previously we are observing special traffic signals we are having. Those special traffic signals are used for the purpose of different important works. If there is any movement of some important people or some political people, or if any accidents or any other fire accidents are there, automatically those fireproof vehicles or fire accident vehicles has to move, and in some of the cases ambulance has to move, so that we have to use these special traffic signals. With respect to this green signal, they are simply sprinkling. This is the normal purpose. This is the normal drawing for a particular signal system. Traffic signal head we are having. First of all, there is a red light. In that particular red light means automatically the total vehicle has to stop. Normally this red light will be useful for the purpose of indication of there is a danger, so that you know won't have to move. After that, we are having this clearance time in the form of this amber. Normally this amber is in the color of yellow color or some light orange color. In some of the places, it depends upon the place to place and people vision capacities, means appearance to the particular people and the area of the. After that, we are having this green. That means a green symbol is used for the freedom. It means you have to move, so that we are using here ghost. These are the three major symbols we are using in the traffic signal purpose. After that, we are having these pedestrian signals. Those pedestrian signals are normally not in our traffic signals. Those are some special signals. What are those? How they have ఎంప్లాయిడ్ ఇన్ దీస్ ట్రాఫిక్ సిగ్నల్స్. ట్రాఫిక్ సిగ్నల్స్లో మనకి ఎందుకు ఇచ్చారు, వాటి యొక్క ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఏంటి? నార్మల్లీ ఇన్ అవర్ ఇండియా దెర్ మే బీ సమ్ లెస్ క్వాంటిటీ ఆఫ్ దీస్ పెడస్ట్రైన్స్ ఇన్ ఫ్యూ ఏరియాస్, బట్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ ఫారెన్ కంట్రీస్ అండ్ అదర్ కంట్రీస్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ యూజింగ్ యాజ్ మచ్ యాజ్ వెహికల్ సింప్లీ ఫర్ ఎనీ ప్లేస్ సింప్లీ మర్ మూవింగ్ ఇన్ టు మూవింగ్ విత్ దేర్ స్మాల్ వెహికల్స్ ఆర్ ఎనీ అదర్ టూ వీలర్స్ ఆర్ దీస్ వాకింగ్ సిస్టమ్ దే ఆర్ యూజింగ్ సో దట్ దీస్ పెడస్ట్రైన్ సిగ్నల్స్ ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ మచ్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇన్ సమ్ కంట్రీస్ హ్యావింగ్ లెస్ క్వాంటిటీ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్. పెడస్ట్రైన్ సిగ్నల్స్ మే బీ ఇన్స్టాల్ ఎట్ ద ఇంటర్సెక్షన్స్ కంట్రోల్డ్ బై ట్రాఫిక్ సిగ్నల్స్ టు ఎనేబుల్ ద పెడస్ట్రైన్స్ టు సేఫ్టీ క్రాస్ ద స్పెషల్ రోడ్స్. దట్ మీన్స్ స్పెషల్ రోడ్స్ మీన్స్ ఆల్ రోడ్స్ ఆర్ నార్మల్లీ స్పెషల్ టు ద పర్టిక్యులర్ స్పెషల్ టు ఎవ్రీ వన్. వై బికాస్ సింప్లీ దే ఆర్ యూజింగ్ దేర్ రోడ్స్ ఫర్ దేర్ జర్నీ సో దట్ దేర్ ఆర్ సమ్ వాట్ స్పెషల్. బట్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ పెడస్ట్రైన్స్ దే నీడ్ టు మూవ్ ఆన్ ఏ పర్టిక్యులర్ రోడ్ విత్ ఎ స్పెషల్ టైమ్ సో దట్ దీస్ లైట్స్ హ్యావ్ టు బ్లింక్ ఇన్ ఏ స్పెషల్ మేనర్ ఫర్ ద పెడస్ట్రైన్ పర్పస్. ఇన్ సచ్ కేసెస్ ద పెడస్ట్రైన్ సిగ్నల్స్ ఆర్ ద ఎంఏ టైమింగ్స్ ఇంటర్లింక్ టు ద ఆపరేట్ అలాంగ్ విత్ ద ట్రాఫిక్ కంట్రోల్ సిగ్నల్స్. దోస్ సిగ్నల్స్ ఆల్సో విల్ హ్యావ్ ఏ బెటర్ అపియరెన్స్ టు ఆల్ ద పీపుల్. వై బికాస్ నార్మల్లీ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ దిస్ గ్రీన్ సిగ్నల్ అండ్ రెడ్ సిగ్నల్ ఫర్ గోయింగ్ అండ్ స్టాపింగ్ ద వెహికల్స్. బట్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ పెడస్ట్రైన్స్ ఆల్సో వీ హ్యావ్ టు గివ్ సమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ట్రా టైమ్ సో దట్ దిస్ యాంబర్ నార్మల్లీ వీఆర్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద క్లియరెన్స్ పర్పస్. లైక్లీ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ సమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ట్రా సిగ్నల్స్ ఫర్ దిస్ పెడస్ట్రైన్స్ వెన్ ఎవర్ దేర్ ఈస్ ఏ హ్యూజ్ క్వాంటిటీ ఆఫ్ మూవ్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ పెడస్ట్రైన్ ఇన్ పర్టికులర్ ఏరియాస్ ఎట్ సర్టెన్ లొకేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ మిడ్ బ్లాక్ స్ట్రెచెస్ ఆఫ్ అర్బన్ రోడ్స్ విత్ హై డిమాండ్ ఫర్ ద పెడస్ట్రైన్ క్రాసింగ్స్. నార్మల్లీ వేర్ దేర్ ఈజ్ ఏ హ్యూజ్ క్వాంటిటీ ఆఫ్ మూవర్స్ ఆన్ ద రోడ్ సో దట్ దేర్ మే బి సమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ట్రా వైడనింగ్ ఆఫ్ రోడ్ ఫర్ ద పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ మూమెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ హ్యూమన్స్. దేర్ మే బి సమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ సమ్ ఎక్స్ట్రా పెయింటింగ్స్ ఆల్సో బి డ్రాన్ ఆన్ ద రోడ్స్ సో దట్ దోస్ పెయింటింగ్స్ ఆర్ నార్మల్లీ విజిబుల్ విత్ వైట్ లైట్స్ దీస్ వైట్ మార్కింగ్స్ ఆల్ దోస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ జీబ్రా క్రాసింగ్స్. దోస్ ఆర్ నార్మల్లీ యూజ్ టు క్రాస్ ద హ్యూమన్స్ అండ్ అదర్ ఇన్ సమ్ కేసెస్ దీస్ యానిమల్స్ అండ్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ ఆల్సో సింప్లీ మూవింగ్ ఆన్ దోస్ సో దట్ దోస్ ఆర్ యూజ్ ఫర్ దీస్ పెడస్ట్రైన్ పర్పసెస్. అప్రాప్రియేట్ వార్నింగ్స్ షుడ్ బి ఇన్ఫర్మేట్లీ సైన్స్ అండ్ ఆల్ దోస్ ఆర్ గివింగ్ వైల్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఏ టైమ్ ఫర్ పెడస్ట్రైన్ మూవ్మెంట్. దట్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద కేసెస్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ఏ హ్యూజ్ క్వాంటిటీ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ సో దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు గివ్ ఏ ప్రాపర్ టైమ్ ఫర్ దేర్ మూవ్మెంట్ విత్ ప్రాపర్ లైటనింగ్ సిస్టమ్. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ దిస్ స్పెషల్ ట్రాఫిక్ సిగ్నల్స్. వాట్ ఆర్ ద డిఫరెంట్ స్పెషల్ ట్రాఫిక్ సిగ్నల్స్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్? ఏ స్పెషల్ ట్రాఫిక్ సిగ్నల్ సచ్ యాజ్ ఫ్లాషింగ్ బికమ్స్ మేబీ ఇన్స్టాల్ ఇన్ సర్టెన్ లొకేషన్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు వార్న్ ద ట్రాఫిక్ ఇన్ సర్టెన్ సిచ్యువేషన్స్. వై బికాస్ స్పెషల్ ట్రాఫిక్స్ ఇఫ్ దెర్ ఈజ్ ఎనీ డిఫరెంట్ పర్పసెస్ ఆఫ్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఆఫ్ రోడ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ ఫర్ ద డిఫరెంట్ పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ద రోడ్స్ దే విల్ ఎంప్లాయ్ సమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఎక్స్ట్రా లైట్స్ ఫర్ ద స్పెషల్ ఆపరేషన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ ట్రాఫిక్ సిగ్నల్స్. స్పెషల్ సిగ్నల్స్ ఆర్ సచ్ ఫర్ ఫ్లాషింగ్ బికమ్స్ మేబీ ఇన్స్టాల్ ఎట్ సర్టెన్ లొకేషన్స్. సర్టెన్ లొకేషన్స్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ ఆల్ లొకేషన్స్ దే డిడెంట్ ఇన్స్టాల్ దీస్ స్పెషల్ సిగ్నల్స్. ఇన్ ఫ్యూ ప్లేసెస్ ఓన్లీ దే విల్ ఇన్స్టాల్ ఫర్ ద బెటర్ మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ట్రాఫిక్ సిచ్యువేషన్స్. ఎట్ ఫ్లాషింగ్ రెడ్ సిగ్నల్స్ ద డ్రైవర్స్ వెహికల్స్ షెల్ స్టాప్ బిఫోర్ ఎంటరింగ్ అంటు ద నియరెస్ట్ క్రాస్ వాక్ ఎట్ ఇంటర్సెక్షన్ అండ్ దే హ్యావ్ టు స్టాప్ ద లైన్. ఫ్లాషింగ్ ఎల్లో సిగ్నల్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో కాషనరీ సిగ్నల్స్ మీన్స్ సైనిఫై ద డ్రైవర్స్ మే ప్రొసీడ్ విత్ కాషన్. దట్ మీన్స్ ఎల్లో సిగ్నల్స్ ప్రీవియస్లీ ఐ డిస్కస్ దిస్ క్యాంబర్ సిగ్నల్ విల్ హ్యావ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ క్లియరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ట్రాఫిక్. ఇన్ ఫ్యూ కేసెస్ దీస్ ఎల్లో సిగ్నల్స్ ఆల్సో యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ స్పెషల్ ట్రాఫిక్ సిగ్నల్ సో దట్ వెన్ ఎవర్ దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ ఫ్లాషింగ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఎల్లో సిగ్నల్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ ద వెహికులర్ డ్రైవర్స్ హ్యాస్ టు టేక్ సమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్రికాషనరీ మెజర్స్.
in their driving. Simply they have to stop the vehicles. After that they need to proceed with a proper caution, means precautionary measures they have to take while they are driving on those places. Next one, what is the Webster method of traffic signal design? Different methods we are having. This particularly Webster method is a famous method for the design of the traffic. In this Webster method, normally the Webster method of traffic signal design is analytical approach of determining the optimum signal cycle time. Cycle time means a complete rotation is there in all directions. That is called as a particular cycle time. In the cycle time also we are having some special kinds of movements corresponding to minimum total delay and all the vehicles at the approach of the roads at the intersections. Webster method of traffic signal is analytical approach. Analytical means normally we have to use our brain and some amount of calculations with the help of data available at a particular locations, and we have to use these cycle times. What is the total number of quantity of the vehicles in a particular space? What is the peak hours we are having? In those peak hours, what is the total length of the traffic standing on a particular road? So that all those data will have to use for the designing of this traffic signal and their times. First of all, the field work consists of determining the following two sets of values, each approach and near the intersection. What are those? Means the normal flow. That means Q means the flow of water. Normally Q equal to flow of water we are designing in the fluid mechanics, but in case of traffic also we are indicating this Q symbol for the flow of vehicles at approach during a design hour. That means design hour means normally we are designing a particular traffic signal in our basis. In that particular hour we have to design, there is a total n number of vehicles, the n number of vehicles are flowing in a particular hour, so that each 1 minute how many vehicles has to move on a particular location. Simply we are dividing the total numbers with 60. We have to get for each minute there is a movement of in number of vehicles. After that we are having the saturation flow S per unit time. That means saturation means some amount of eclipse or some amount of disturbance in terms of the saturations. Those are also we have to take for the complete design. After that, the normal flow values Q1, Q2 on roads 1 and 2 determined from field studies. That means field study means simply a few number of people are employed in a particular roads. We are having Q1 and Q2 roads. On roads means Q1 means quantity of vehicles are moving on a first road. Q2 means quantity of vehicles are moving on second road. So that the field itself, a few persons has to study the total number of vehicles are moving on a quantity road 1 in a particular hour. So that those studies will helpful for us for designing these traffic signal patterns for a particular 15 minutes of period. That means on 15 minutes total number of vehicles are going in a particular road, so that it will use the data with respect to n number. The saturation flow of vehicles determined by careful field studies, nothing. The number of vehicles in the stream compact to few during the green phases and the corresponding time of intervals respectively. That means the saturation flow of vehicles also determined by careful field studies, means we have to observe with our naked eyes, so that nothing, the number of vehicles in stream of compact flow during the green phases. That means in the green phase means whenever there is a green light is blowing on a particular intersection, so that in that particular intersection of the period, intersection of place, how many number of vehicles are flowing on particular green period. That means green period means the green light is blowing for a period of 2 to 3 minutes, so that in that 2 to 3 minutes how many number of vehicles are moving, all those things also we need to count. Those comes under this saturation flow. So First of all, we have to flow, you count for normal flow. That means the total number of vehicles are flowing for a design period of 15 minutes. After that, we have to go for, this is saturation flow. Saturation flow means the total number of vehicles are simply moving in the green. Whenever there is a green light is blowing, automatically in that particular period, the total number of vehicles are moving. All those comes under this saturation flow. After that, in the absence of the data, appropriate value of saturation flow is estimated by assuming the 160 PCU per 0.3 meter width of the approach road. For suppose if the road is less important, that means in few of the places we are having too much of importance, depending upon the place values and site values, we have to go for the collection of data. In some of the cases, there may be less quantity of traffic. In those times, we have to use this IRC recommendations. That means IRC means Indian Road Congress has prescribed a plenty of these rules and regulations where we have to follow, so that we have to use those IRC recommendations. Normally, we have to calculate this PCU, means passenger car units. Normally, passenger car units, having already discussed, passenger car unit means what is the passenger car unit for a car, what is the passenger car unit for a bicycle, likely tractor, load carrying vehicles, likely animal cart vehicles, bull cart vehicles, likely we are having different PCUs for different vehicles. So that bicycle having a PCU of 0.5, car having a PCU of 1, and a tractor having a PCU of 3, and this load, the lorries having a PCU of 1.5, mini lorries. Likely we have to know those terms, and according to those PCU values, we have to give some amount of value with appropriate, which is related to the width of the road. The total PCU means passenger car units are directly proportional to the width of the road. Why? Because if the width of the road increases, automatically this PCU value also increases. Width of the road decreases, PCU value also decreases. Why? Because those two are directly proportional. Directly proportional means if the increment of one, automatically second one also increase. If the decrement of one, automatically second one also decrease. Those are directly proportional. Then what is inversely proportional means, if one value increases, another value automatically decreases, means those two are related to directly proportional. So that we need to mind those two things, what is directly proportional and what is indirectly proportional. So that if the width of the road and PCU having, we are directly proportional. So that we need to have some importance to those two things, PCU value and width of the road. In a particular space, what is the normal width of the road? So that according to those width, what is the PCU value we are having? Those two things we have to remember. Based on the selected values of the normal flow and the ratio, that means y1 equal to q by s1 and y2 equal to q by s2, determined by the approaches of the road 1 and 2. In this particular study, they are simply doing only for two roads, that means lane 1 and lane 2. In the particular lane 1, we are having a flow of y2 equal to total quantity by s1, y1 equal to quantity 1 by s1, y2 equal to quantity 2 by s2. So that for approaching 1 and 2. After that, they are calculating this C0, optimum signal cycle is given by 1.5 L plus 5 by 1 minus y, where y is this average value for the lines. y1 and y2 we are having, y equal to average value, where here L equal to the total lost time per cycle, that means 2n plus r, where n equal to number of phases. That means if the total, if there is a cross section, there is a combination of 4 to 5 roads, so that we have to having these 4 phases or 3 phases, depending upon the lines of merging at a particular point. So that phases depends upon the lines of merging, so that n equal to number of phases. After that, we are having here r equal to all minus ready time or ready amber time. All means the total time period minus ready time, will give the directly r symbol. here we are having y equal to y1 plus y2, y1 equal to q1 by s1, y2 equal to q2 by s2. So that we need to design, this is g1 equal to y1 by y of c0 minus l, where c0 is calculated in the above equation, and l also we are having total lost time per cycle. So that by using these formulas we have to calculate the total time period required for the red period, red zone and green zone times. That means whatever the time required for blinking of this red light, whatever the time required for the blinking of green light in a particular space. Design method per as per IRC regulations. Previously we are observed this is the foreign method, that is called as the Webster method. That means Webster is a foreigner, so that the name given as Webster method. After that, by using the different philosophies and different prescribed measures in other countries, the Indian Road Congress has prescribed a salient features for our traffic flow, so that we have to know what are the salient features. First of all, the pedestrian green time required for the major and minor roads are calculated based upon the walking speed of 1.2 meter per second or initially walk time of 2.0 seconds. That means first of all, in that particular traffic signal, in a particular intersection of the area, we have to give preference to these pedestrians. Why? Because the pedestrians having a different moving capacity compared to the normal vehicle purpose. After that, we need to have the minimum green time required for the vehicle traffic and minor and comma major roads respectively. So that what is the minimum time required according to the traffic conditions. Next one, green time required for the vehicular traffic or major road increased in a proportion of the traffic on the two approach roads. If it is a single road, we need to go for minimum lane. If it is a double lane road, we have to calculate by different phenomena. The cycle time is calculated after the allowing amber time of 2 seconds each. That means if there is a complete down of cycle time, automatically we have to give some amount of clearance time with respect to 2 to 3 seconds normally we are giving for each cyclist of closing. That means if it is a red cycle, it is a green signal, automatically after the completion of green signal we have to give a 2 to 3 seconds of break. After that we need to blow another red signal to another direction. The minimum green time required for a clearing vehicles arriving duration of a vehicle is determined by each lane of approach red, assuming that first vehicle will take 6 seconds and subsequent vehicles of the PCU Q will be depends upon the clearance rate of the 2 seconds. First of all, we have to give a much important to speak passenger car units. What are the major amount of passenger car units on those particular area? So that according to that particular area, we have to design. So that if it is all vehicles are cars or vehicles are bicycles or large load carrying vehicles, depending upon those, we have to give some amount of fixation of time. Why? Because if all vehicles are two-wheelers and we are designed for large load carrying vehicles, means there may be huge amount of variation of time with respect to these red signals and green signals. So that we have to collect the data for every 15 minutes. In the particular 15 minutes period, what are the number of vehicles are going? We need to mind and we have to go for study. The optimum signal time is calculated by using this Webster formula. After that, the saturation flow values assumed 1950, 1850, 1950, 2020, 2250, 2500 to PCUs with different approaches of the width of the roadway and 3, 4, 4.4 and 5.5 meters, depending upon the total values we are having is 1850 to 2250, 2900, total all are the PCUs for a different loan rates lanes of the roads, and those width of the lanes are 3 meters and up to 5.5 meters we are having. For width is above 5.5 meters, the saturation flow may be assumed to 525 PCU per hour per meter width of the road. That means the width of the road is 5 meters. That means only x direction we are having, width of the road 5.5 meters, and there may be assumed PCU value of 520 per hour. That means in a particular hour, 60 minutes of time, there may be 525 vehicles are flowing per meter length. If there is n number of meters, then automatically we need to multiply 525 with n meters. They will give direct the flow of the vehicles in a particular hour. There may be a lost time is calculated the initial inter green and other parameters, so that the initial delay time will be taken as a 4 second for first vehicles on each leg. This is the total signal time they are giving. The signal time and the phase may be received by keeping the view of the green time required for the clearing the vehicles and optimum cycle length determined from the steps above. It means here we are having a different steps. First one, we are having Webster formula. In those Webster formula, we are using different saturation values according to, we are having 1850, 1890, 1950, 2250, 2500 and 2990. All those are the passenger car units. So that Webster method having mainly depends upon these PCU values. After that, we are giving a preference to the lines of the road. Okay, but in case of our IRC, it is directly giving preference to passenger car units with respect to a meter length. We have to compare those two things. In the Webster method, we are having this flow PCU values, and they are directly the PCU value, depending upon the PCU values, they are designing the total time required for the red signals and green signals. But in case of our IRC signals, they are completely depends upon the length of the road. For each length, we are having a particular quantity of vehicles are moving for hour. So that for a 1 meter road, 525 vehicles with 5.5 meter span are moving. Likely, we have to assume for n number of meters in a particular hour, what is the total quantity of vehicles. So that for that quantity of vehicles, what is the time required? In the previous one, we are having these formulas, C naught equal to 1.5 into L. Here, L equal to where length of the total lost time. After that, we are having N equal to total number of phases, R equal to all time minus red signal time. So, these all are the formulas used for the calculation of this Webster method and IRC method. But in case of IRC method, there is only simply time they are giving. In that particular time, what is the total quantity of vehicles moving? So that for each and every vehicles, we are giving a 5 seconds, a 4 to 5 seconds. Here in the third signal, third sentence, we are having this red system, red lines. Initial delay of 4 seconds for first vehicles on each leg. It is the minimum time they are giving. By using that minimum time, the total number of vehicles we are having 525 PCUs. So that they are multiplying those values and simply getting time required for the particular red signal and particular green signal and amber signals. That means 2 to 3 seconds normally we are giving. If it is a large area, how much amount of time we have to give, it depends upon number of lanes we are using. It is the total design of our signal systems, the traffic signals and objectives of traffic signals, advantages and disadvantages of traffic signals. These are the basic terms, that means definitions we are using in the traffic signals, and different kinds of the traffics, what is control, pedestrian and special times, about there and the notations we are using in the particular traffic lights. After that, we need to elaborate what is a pedestrian signal, what is the purpose of giving pedestrian signal. Next one, what is the special traffic signal, what is the necessity of providing these special traffic signals. After that, we are having a design philosophy about this Webster method, and this is the formulas you are using in the Webster method. Next one, as per IRC guidelines, what is the minimum time required for controlling the vehicles. These are the prescribed ones.